is the demo on date functions in Oracle. Some simple date functions we will see. First of all, you have to see the date data type. So how will you insert a date? Let me create an employee table, create a table employee. I'll call this EMP. And I'll have ID to be of type number. Now employee will have a join date when he joined the organization. So this is a date field, so I have to give date as the data type. The next, you can also have a retirement date or else retire date, that will be a date field again. So whenever you have a date, you mention that as date. So this is the data type. So you give it as date and you create the table. Table is created. When you describe the table, you can see the data type is date for the two dates we have mentioned, join date and retire date. Now, what should be the format of the date we are going to enter? The default format supported is DDMONYY. So that is the default format of Oracle. Let me insert and show you how to insert this date. So it's insert into emp values. We'll insert ID to be, say, 123. The join date, let's say you joined on 21st September 1990. I have to give it like this. Say you retired on, let's enter 27th October 2020. So I'll just give 20. So I've entered two dates now. So we'll retrieve the date, select star from emp. So you maintain dates, and once when you have the dates inserted in your records, you can do a lot of things with dates. You can find the difference between two dates. You can also add some days to a date. You can find the difference in months. We can find the last date of a last day of a particular date with respect to the month. There are a lot of things we can do. We'll look at it one by one. Say we can also look at the system date, say the current date. How will you access the current date is we'll do select sys date from dual. Dual is a dummy table in Oracle. You can just use it for selecting sys date. So now this gives the current date, 7th July 21st. So you can always add days to the sys date or any date. For instance, I can do select sys date plus one. I can perform this from dual. So it means I'll add one more day, that is 8th July 21. If I subtract 10 days, what will happen? Select sys date minus 10 from dual. So it's going to work as dates here. So it's going to take me to the previous month. So it gives me 27 June 2021. So you can access sys date. You can also add some days. So when you add some numbers, it adds it as days. And when you subtract some number, it subtracts it as days. So that's how you work with sys date. And you should not divide two dates. I can't do sys date by join date. I cannot divide two days. I cannot multiply two dates. I should not do sys date star join date. So multiplication, division of two dates is not allowed, but addition with respect to number of days is allowed. So I hope you're clear with how you work with sys date. Now we'll see how to extract. Say sometimes I want to extract only the day, whether it is 21st or 22nd. I want to extract the month in terms of a number. I want to extract the year. For that, we can use the extract function, that is select extract. We have to give month from whichever column, join date from emp table. So this actually is going to extract the month alone from the join date. Let's see, it says the month is 9. So what is that? We have select star from emp. So join date September is the 9th month. So we are able to extract the month alone from the date. Likewise, we can also extract the day alone. How will you extract? It's very simple. Select extract day from join date, whichever column, from emp. So now I've extracted the day alone. I can also extract the year alone. How will I extract year? Now you would have guessed it. It's select. Extract is the function year from join date from emp. So now the year I have inserted is 1990. So that is what I have extracted, right? 1990 I have extracted. So you can extract any values you wanted. I mean, you can extract the day, the month, or the year as per your needs by using the extract function. Is that clear for all of you? So that is how you work with extract function. Next, we will see some more functions like months between, add months, last day, trunk function, and toCAR function. So we'll now go with the next thing. We'll see months between function. What is the use of months between? Say I'll go with this select star from emp. I have a join date. Suppose I want to find the total months between the join date and the current date. How will I be able to find that? I'll give this function select months between. So what it takes is we give the current date and then the join date from emp. So now it finds the difference in months and gives you the total number of months. If I want to find the years, I am getting months. If I want the years, I'll just divide it by 12. So I'll just take this, divide by 12 to get the number of years. So that is the number of years between the current date and the joining date of the employee. Suppose I want to round this one off, I can also round it. I will use exactly, I want just in the number of years. I don't want any 0.79 or something. I can go with a round if I want to. I'm just saying it's optional. So if I just round the entire result so that I get 31 years as the output. So you can use months between to find the months between two dates. You can also add months to a given date. Say we have seen how to add days, right? How will you add days? You can say select this date plus one. So that will add number of days, one day it will add. If I want to add months, I have to use this function, add months. Say if the current date is this date, how many months I want to add? 3 months from dual. So if I perform this, you'll see it adds 3 months to the current date and displays the output. So you have add months, months between, you have seen extracting the several parts of a date. The next thing we will see is another interesting thing called the last day. We'll see what is this function, last day, what it does. It's a interesting function, select last day of this date from dual. So what it does is it displays the last day of the month for the current date. So the current date is actually 7th July. The last day in the month of July is 31st July. 2021. So last day retrieves us the last date of the current month, that is of the current date. So if you what this query does is last day will retrieve the last day of the month mentioned in the date field here. Here we have given this date, which is the current date. So the last day is 31st July 21. So if you want to find the first day of the month, it's not first underscore day, that is a little different. It is select trunc, trunc, and then you give the sys date and you have to mention month in quotes here. It's a little different. It's not first date as you, first day as you think. It is trunc, sys date, month from dual. So this will return the first day of the return the first day of the month for the date we have mentioned. Here we are given this date, so it should be 1st July 21st. So last day will mention the last day of the month for the date you are giving here. TRUNC, this function will give the first day of the month for the date you are giving here. So that's about add months, last day, trunc function, and we'll see one more thing that is quite interesting, that is toCAR. Say if I just do select star from M, This is the format of the date that is getting printed, the default format. Suppose I want to print it like 21st September 1990. How can I print that format? I have to use this function, select 2_char, and then we have to give the date that which we are going to use, join date we are going to now use, and print it like this, that is DD month. And say if I want to print it in the format YYYY, I can give that. So from emp, from the table name. So now you see, I'm just printing this particular date in this format, 21st September 1990. Even this 1990, I want to expand and print in words. I can do that. For that, I have to just give year, year. Now you see that is printed as 21st September 1990. Even this one, this DD, I can just mention that as day. Now what happens? You see Friday, September 1990. How far it goes. So you can very well have any of the formats that you want to give here. It follows that format. Now, when I give MON, it just displays September. Say, when you're writing applications, you may need the dates to be displayed in a certain format for the user, no matter how it is stored in the database. So you'll retrieve that in this format and display it to the user. That is the use of this two-char function. And it'll also be useful for printing the hours, minutes, and seconds. When you talk about a date, the timestamp is also is part of the date. So I can do select 2char, and then I can give this date, and I can mention this. Say I want to just display it like this: DD month, and then YYYY, and then the number of hours, minutes, and seconds. So I can also display it like this. I hope this should work. Let's check on dual. So now it gives you, the data, right? 7th July 2021, 6 hours 7 minutes and 6 seconds. So that is the format. You can also print the time along with the date. So that's how you work with date. Some of the functions we have seen with the dates, we have seen how to insert, how to extract parts of the date, how to add months, how to add days, how to print the date in a format that we require. And we have also seen some functions like add months, last day, and truncate. And we have also seen how to calculate the number of years between two given dates. There's one interesting thing that we have to understand in Oracle. Say if I insert a date in the table, say let me insert and show you. There's one thing that's happening here. Say insert into emp values. Let me insert the another employee 124. Is join date. Say I will give the join date as 24th I'll give January. And here, the year I'm going to mention it as 51. And the retiring date, let me mention this as 25th, or else I'll just give 24th January. And I'll say the retirement date to be, say, 59. Or else I'll say 49. It's pretty funny to give something like this, just to understand this, how this thing works. Say now, what do you think will be inserted? Do you think 24th January 2051 should be inserted? Because I'm just giving 51 year, and 24th January 2049 is the retirement date. Say to make it more sensible, let me make it say he joins in 24th January 2049 and he retires in 2051. So we are entering something like this. Are you understanding this? We are entering 49, it means 2049, and 51, which means 2051. Now let's enter. Let's see whether the records are getting inserted. Yes, now let's run select 2char. We'll say join date. We'll give the format DD MON YYYY and comma 2char. We'll also get the retire date now. Retire date, we'll give the format DD MON YYYY from emp table. So now if I give this, where ID is equal to 124. what should be the output? Let's see. Okay, there's something missing here. That is just a column that I have left. Okay, again an issue. I have missed this closing the quotes here too. So let me see now. Now you see the difference. Say this was inserted. When I inserted 49, it took it as 2049. But when I inserted 51, it just converted it as 1951. So Oracle, what it does is it takes dates up to 2049 as 2049. If you start inserting anything greater than 49, like 50 or 51, it converts that to 1950 and 1951. So you have to be very cautious. Say if I again insert and show you, if I insert a record like this, 24 Jan 50 and 24 Jan 52, what happens here? When I do a select star from employee, select to care join date where ID is equal to 124. Okay. So again, the same errors because of running the previous query with the same error issues. Let me close the quotes. Now you see, when I give 50, whatever that is greater than 49, it converts that to 1950. Whatever that is greater than 49, it's not 2050, it's 1950. So how will you handle this issue? Suppose I want to enter it as 2050. How can I enter that is? It's just very simple. You mention 2050 and 2052. Because when you don't mention, it converts that to 1950 and 1952. Now if I do select to care, and then if I run this query, you can see now it is 2050 and 2052. So this is something that happens internally. So it allows only till 2049 if you just mention it as 49. Okay, so that's about the date functions in Oracle. I hope you are clear with this.